Next kind is interrogative pronoun. Children, whenever we listen to this word interrogative, only one thing clicks in our mind, that is WH, family members. Obviously, an interrogative pronoun is used to ask a question. Interrogative pronouns are who, whom, which, what, whoever, whomever, whichever, and whatever. Whom, who, which can be used as relative pronouns also. Who, whom, and sometimes which are used to refer to people, which and what are used to refer to things and animals. In both the ways, it can be used. Which is your house? It is not a compulsion that these WH family members will be used as a subject also. They can be used as a subject. They can be used object of the verb. They can be used object of the preposition too. It can be object also. Which is your house? Which is your house? As a subject, it has been used. Who wanted to go? Obviously, as a subject. Further, in the examples, to whom do you wish to speak? Object of the preposition to. To whom do you? To is preposition here. So, object of the preposition to, it has been, whom has been used here. Another example, you can marry whomsoever you like. Whomsoever you like. You has been this. You like, you has been used as an object here. So, whomsoever has been used with object. Further, we have reflexive or emphatic pronoun. Always remember, children, whenever reflexive or emphatic pronoun will be used, they will not be alone. They will always have self with them. The reflexive pronoun have the same form as the emphatic or intensive pronoun. They indicate that the subject of the sentence also receives the action of the verb. The reflexive pronoun reflects the subject of the sentence. Example, she enjoyed herself fully. I myself opened the door. He himself completed his work. You yourself are responsible for the result. In the same way, you can see, children. She enjoyed herself fully. Herself fully, herself reflexive pronoun. She subject, enjoyed verb. The emphatic pronouns emphasize a noun or pronoun. I already gave you examples. She herself decided to go. He himself is to be blamed. I myself will do all this. You yourself are guilty. Children, further we have sixth type, that is reciprocal pronoun. In reciprocal pronoun, each other, vice versa, each other, one another will be used. Each other is more frequently used than one another, but when more than two people or things are involved, one another is often preferred. Although we have started pronouncing it often also, it is also correct pronunciation, children. We can bring two sentences together by using a reciprocal pronoun. How? Ram likes Sita, Sita likes Ram. So we can easily convert by using reciprocal pronoun. We can convert in a single sentence. Ram and Sita like each other. All the three boys are quite different from one another. They help one another when they can, when they are in need. Me and my cousin help each other whenever we need. So, in the same way, reciprocal pronoun have been used. Further, next is indefinite pronoun. Indefinite means nothing is fixed. Anything can be there, anybody can be there, anytime it can be, anywhere it can be. And here are some pronouns which show the indefinite. The indefinite pronoun do not refer to any specific person or thing. The most common indefinite pronouns are all, another, any, anybody, anyone, anything, each, everybody, and so on. And the easiest pronoun, children. Examples are also here. All are equal in the eyes of God. We are not pointing I, you, me, he, she, it. We are not pointing any personally. We are not pointing out anyone personally, but rather indefinite. Anyone can be there. Anything can be there. She doesn't like this doll. Let her choose another. Any another. Anything will be done for the present. Nobody was at home. Somebody is knocking at the door. We don't know that who is knocking at the door. So, indefinite. Somebody is knocking at the door. I have heard a sound. Someone is calling me. I don't know who is calling me. So, that is indefinite pronoun. Last, relative pronoun. Children, the name itself is making its meaning clear. A relative pronoun is used to join one phrase or clause to another phrase or clause. Some of the relative pronouns are who, whom, that, which, whose, etc. We use the relative pronoun who to refer of the subject of a sentence. Whom is used as object of a verb, preposition, etc. Here is the example. The boy whom you met is my brother. The girl who is standing at the door is my cousin. The lady who is in blue dress is my aunt. The best decision that I can take is to go at once. So these pronouns have been used as relative pronoun here. They are connected with subject and object. In any way, they are connected with subject either or with object. Always remember, children, that who is used for persons, which is used for things, that can be used for both persons and things. So, children, this was all about the explanation of pronouns. Listen to the video again if any doubt is there, and make sure that you all will always attend Zoom session, as well as you all will take your CTs regularly. On the basis of the explanation of this chapter pronoun, make sure that you will do the exercise yourself, and further, if you will do the exercise only, then the doubts can be taken. Thank you, children.